الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الله سبحانه وتعالى سأل: إن الشيطان لكم عدو فاتخذوه عدوا. الله سبحانه وتعالى سأل: Verily, the shaitan is your enemy, so you be an enemy to him. I want to remind myself and you that it is very important to take this aggressive stand against the shaitan, not only to prevent the wasafis of shaitan, but to actually do something about it. Now, first thing is, with respect to other enemies and people who are maybe against you in one way or the other, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that we should idfa billatihi ahsan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, return to them whatever they do. If they are doing negative to you, return to them in a positive manner. Because there is in the human being, no matter how bad a person might be, there is always, the fitra is good. So there is always some spark of goodness. And when you return evil with good, then that spark of goodness gets strengthened. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then said, Waliyun Hamim, that person will become like a dear friend of yours, even though he may have started off as an enemy. But with the shaitan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, first ties billah. Take the panah, take the protection of Allah. Because shaitan is pure evil. There is no spark of any goodness in shaitan. So therefore you do not do idfa billati with regard to shaitan. With regard to shaitan, the first thing to do is A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. First, A'udhu billahi. So we take the panah, we take the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from shaitan. The second thing is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Fattakhizu adwa. Become his enemy. Now how do you become the enemy of shaitan? You become the enemy of shaitan by deliberately doing what shaitan tells you not to do. So for example, if the shaitan tells you, it's not yet time for tahajjud, why should you wake up now, you know, sleep for another half an hour, after another 1.5 hours to Fajr, then wake up at that time. Instead of waking up at 3 o'clock, wake up at 2 o'clock. Only to confound the shaitan. When you are giving some sadaqah, and shaitan says, no, why should you give so much money here? Give double that. Then he will scream up and down, and then you give some more, until he shuts up and runs away. When you are in any good work, if the shaitan tells you do not do it, then do more of that. Second thing, how do you become the enemy of shaitan? Is identify within yourself things which are your and my personal weaknesses. Everyone has got a different weakness. For example, for me, not watching a Deccan Chargers match, not watching a one day international or an IPL cricket match, for me is no mujahida, because I don't like cricket. For me, not watching the match is no problem. For me, not watching the World Cup football is no problem. I don't want to watch it. I have absolutely no interest in it whatsoever. For me, not to go to a shopping mall is absolutely no problem, because I hate shopping malls. I hate shopping and I hate shopping malls. I don't even buy my own shoes. So for me, if I say, you know, same thing with television. I absolutely detest television. We don't have a phone television in our house. Can you believe that? In this day and age, we have no TV. Because we don't want a TV, we have no desire for a TV. So for me, if I say that, you know, I'm not watching television, it's so much that I don't want to watch television. But there may be some other things which I want to do, which are either haram, or even if, alhamdulillah, if we have reached a stage where we do not do haram, this is inshallah not possible, we do not do haram. But there may be other things we do which are not haram, but which are also not things of any benefit to us. Something which does not give us any sawab, something which does not give us any reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at best it's a waste of time. Now that is something to guard against, because that is the first step which takes you towards what is haram. That is why Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi said, even the thought of sin, just the thought, alhamdulillah, inshallah, we are not accountable, Allah will not hold us accountable for thoughts. But even Imam Ghazali said, even the thought of sin, kill it, finish it. Because the thought will lead to the speech, and the speech will lead to the action. So he said, if you keep the thought in your mind, you will talk about it. Once you start talking about it, then it opens the doors for actually committing that sin. So he said, do not even think about it. So that's why, how do you become the enemy of Shaitan? Identify the specific thing within yourself, which is either the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or something which is against the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or something which, even if it is not these two things directly, it is just a waste of time and a waste of energy. It's some action on which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to reward us. And that is the thing which we focus on, and we say, no, I will not do this. Now, one of the most common ones of that, especially in our culture, is our friends. May Allah protect us from friends who will be a source of problem for us on the Day of Judgment. So we are in this city especially, we are addicted to parties. Some excuse. If there is no excuse, then we have a party because there is no excuse. Some party, some this dawat here, that dawat there, you know, dawat is dawat of Islam, not dawat of biryani or halim. But for us, dawat is dawat of biryani and halim. So every day, somewhere, you meet the same people, you talk the same stuff, and then Subhanallah, may Allah protect us, but most, a lot of times, riba and this and that, because what else is there to talk? Or we talk about what should be done to Anna Hazare who is sitting in Tihar jail. How does it make any damn of a difference to you or me, what is happening in Tihar jail or not happening in Tihar jail? Nobody is asking for our opinion. Even if we give an opinion, it has no effect on something. Layani bakwas. I mean, just nonsensical talk, which has absolutely no effect in this dunya, but which has effect in the akhirah. So I think we must be very, very careful with this. Pick your friends. Just say no. What is the problem with this two-letter word? What about no, do you not understand? If somebody says, please come, you say, I will not come. Jazakallahu khairan, may Allah give you the reward for this niyyah, I will not come. Khalas. And believe me, nothing happens. Your popularity will not decrease. I am the most antisocial human being in the city. Have you ever seen me in anybody's house, in any party? But I am also the person to whom the maximum number of people come to meet. Alhamdulillah. Makes no difference. In any case, popularity makes no difference. Whether you are popular or unpopular makes no difference. So let us be very clear. Keep friends which take us towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Friends which take us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or with whom there is a waste of time and energy, discard those friends. And then identify the things in our lives which are the weaknesses which Shaitan exploits, and eliminate them. I'm not saying reduce them, eliminate them. Because my brothers, the time when we have to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. The time is very near. And therefore, let us not waste even one second more of our lives. Alhamdulillah, this month comes to remind us of that. Let us try to make the maximum benefit of that. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us to do this. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyil kareem wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajmain. Bi rahmatika ya ahmar rahim.